Hey everybody, Joe Heygood here, aka mclazyj. We're gonna be playing some Hellblade. Last time we played this, we had just beaten Val Revan and had come back to the main lobby and went through the door that was finally unlocked since we had already beaten Surt.
The darkness touched you. Everyone could see it in the hollows of your eyes. A gaze averted from life.
We had already watched this part, but I guess it means we have to watch it again.
Led it to him. An endless suffering worse than death. And you wanted to surrender, abandon, and find peace with the gods. No. The darkness won't allow it. So you will walk into the lair of the beast. Look it in the eye, and you will go to war. This is your mission. This is your quest. There is nothing else left.
Okay. Time with the shield guy.
Every gate you open into darkness brings another challenge.
Thank you.
Journey to Helheim.
However you come to the gold-covered bridge that leads to Hell, you may find it guarded by a giantess. She will ask your name. She will ask your lineage. She will ask your business. The Northmen tell of the warrior woman Brynhild, who leapt into fire and rode to Hell to join her slain love Sigurd. That is challenged.
Kumbaya!
Hela possesses large dwelling places in Helheim. Tall are her walls, high
okay.
are her gates. The name of her dish is hunger. Her knife is famine,
On her threshold, all will stumble. Her bed is called Sick Bed, and her bed hangings are called Flames of the Fire. They say she is easy
Mr.
to
Andrew hold. Hawkins.
Half black.
I just noticed you had followed the channel. Flesh. I apologize for not paying attention
her
earlier.
Face. Menacing and grim. Disgrace. The gods will punish you for this. Pick up the sword. Pick it up. Fight the darkness. Fight it. Get up. Get up. Get up and fight.
So well.
Stormy seas and lost souls. She's dreamt of this before. They say dreams are visions of our memories, thoughts, and fears, as seen by our inner eye. But what if each one of us is always dreaming, even when awake? And we only see what our inner eye creates for us. Is this what hell is? A world shaped by Senua's nightmares. Maybe that's why people feared seeing the world through our eyes. Because if you believe that Senua's reality is twisted, you must accept that yours might be too.
You fail the gods. You're pathetic. Rotten.
Wow.
Cursed.
Her inner self is really mean
what
to her.
Thinking? Did you really think you could win? How stupid can you be? Everyone hates her. She's cursed.
The shadow.
Look at you. A warrior. Worthless. Weak, pathetic, poor. Feel sorry for yourself because there's no one left to do that for you.
What's that?
Take it. If you're too much of a coward to fight, then end the suffering. Broken and lost. Just grab your sword.
Jesus. That was disturbing.
Why go on? When you give everything and face that which torments you, only to find that it is worse than you could have imagined. Why go on? Is it really so weak to ask this? Or are we just so afraid of the honest answer that we do not dare pose the question? Sometimes the answer lies in a memory, a feeling, a song.
It's a trick, don't trust it.
spent all that time getting on that damn bridge, and now we got knocked
it's
off
him.
Of everything.
There he is. It can't be him. It's just a trick. It's in your mind.
No, he's here.
It's in your mind.
It's real.
So, go towards it. Before she first met him, she was not in a good place. Just a teenager, but not like the others. Barely functioning, she rarely left the house. Her father Zimbel made sure of that. Only occasionally did she venture out on her own, collecting firewood and herbs.
Okay, I wanna see. It does work pretty good.
Out in the Orkney Plains. That was her world. Like this one. Barren and lonely. She remembers the first time she saw him. Her young eyes, he moved as if dancing. And the world danced with it. The gloom lifted. The first time in years, she felt a ray of hope.
Oh, I see that. There's a lock there. Up there, let's just see how it is.
all.
What is she following? You can't even fight. It's just deception.
How does he so effortlessly court the world and bliss? If only she could do the same.
Okay.
See the world through eyes anew.
What's your name?
Huh.
Senua.
I haven't seen you before.
I'm not. I don't leave home much.
Oh. Zeno's daughter.
I have to go.
Wait. Who taught you to fight like that?
No one.
No one?
Well, I watched you. And.
You learned all of that from watching me? You should become a warrior, you know.
Me?
Must be how they first met.
I'm Dilly. I'm here for the warrior trials. Just come and watch. Bring your sword.
You can't put it into words.
Uh-oh, and it all disappeared.
When you look into the eyes of the one who's supposed to reassure you,
tree is
make
dead.
You feel safe. It only takes an instant. Fear swallows you before you have a chance to make sense of it. And darkness becomes a part of who you are.
You killed him.
But her will changed the day the Northmen took him from her. So no one knows that there's no going back to how things were. That there's nothing to go back to at all.
Stay still, stay quiet, hide, don't tell her.
Their gods can see into your mind. They will use this power to destroy you.
They won't stop me. I can still feel him.
Whatever's left of him, they will never let him go.
I'm not gonna let him rot here.
You're the one rotting here.
Leave me alone.
You will die here. And all your suffering will have been for nothing.
The Northmen tell of a great hero.
Always ends up being one of them somewhere.
His name is Sigmund. His father's hall was built around a great tree, and one day, Odin comes and thrusts a sword into the tree, a gift to whomever can release it. Many try, but the sword only comes out of Sigmund's touch.
Aha.
King in the north forced the dwarves to make a sword that would never fail and never rust, and that would slice through iron and stone and bring victory to its bearer. Huh. But the angry dwarves cursed it. It would be the death of a man every time it was drawn. And it would be the death of the king. Let me tell you about the sword Tyrving.
I don't recognize this name. Where is she? It feels wrong.
Huh.
Where are we now?
We're in a different place now.
Burial mound. So strange that we go to such lengths to bury death. Something so very ordinary. Inevitable.
Huh.
It's as if we conspire to hide death.
There's that.
Because we have no answer for it.
Finally end up, I believe.
But when it comes,
it's not certain, but I think that's
it forces itself onto our friends or loved ones. Then comes the reckoning.
Of a story that the Northmen tell about a young woman warrior. Her name is Hervor, the daughter of a berserker born after he was killed. She's a wild, willful child who teaches herself to fight with weapons. When she learns where her father is buried, her only desire is to reclaim the treasure buried with him, but above all, the sword, Tyrving. Disguises herself as a man to join a band of warriors, and soon becomes their leader. When they come to the island where her father is buried, her men do not want to go ashore. They say that evil haunts the island, and that it is a worse place by day than other places are by night. Fearless, she lands alone. There are many grave mounds, and all of them have ghostly flames burning over them. She comes to the grave mound of her father after passing through these ghostly fires as though they were mist. The flames I passed through were real enough. Damn the Northmen to hell.
want to or not, there's no way to get out. But if I go the other way, I'm just repeating the same way. Something different.
Light the torch. Light it. Look for the torch. Light it.
It'll help you see.
It'll help you see. Where are we? She has no idea. You think that sound is Dillian's voice? It's a trap. You've walked right into their hands. They have you right where they want you. How could you? You think that voice is Dillian's?
It's not.
It's beckoning you to your death.
Thank you.
it's not dying.
See the darkness in your eyes, child.
I meant a boy.
Boy? No.
He said he could help me.
It's a trick.
He said it could be normal.
Normal?
Yes.
No boy is going to save you. No one can.
Wow.
When they see the rot growing inside you, they will turn their back on you. The gods can only fix you through my hand. You're going nowhere.
Wow.
No.
You will not defy the gods. Come, child, take my hand. Come. Senua.
Yes! I am leaving!
You cannot escape the darkness. Your curse will make everyone suffer. You will have blood on your hands!
Wow. That wasn't creepy at all.
What if this is pointless? What if you're wrong? What if this has nothing to do with the soul? What if we're wrong? The soul will never be. What if this is the end? It's just a trick.
Not that way.
You've been fooled before. You could be fooled again. You're being tested. You don't know. It's just their game for you. You never know which way it's going to go.
Walk all the way around. Alright, let's see if we can get this one finished, and then we'll probably take a break for a little while.
It was so terrible that not the oldest man among us could remember the like. Hundreds died.
The sickness took nearly
every person younger than 40, and many older.
Apparently I have four.
Where dying mothers gave birth, the marks of the plague were on the babes as they came out of the womb.
But it seems like I'm actually probably about halfway through. Over halfway through now in the game.
I don't like it. This place feels... What is this place? This place feels... It's... creepy.
The swamp.
It feels wrong. It feels strange. Where is it? Where are we? This is wrong. This has to be wrong.
Your warrior trials. Dillian will help me.
Just one little test to do. You can always reach it.
The stench of rot. She can almost taste it. Do you smell it? No. Don't worry. Not everyone can. Spring day when she went to the river with Dillian and the others. But the water. She could taste the rot. No one else could. She knew something was wrong. Something sinister. She begged them to leave, but they just laughed at her. But soon enough, as the bodies piled up, no one was laughing. And they knew that she was not like them. The bridge. It's broken. You have to find him. Quick, get to the house. Get to the house and finish this trial.
It doesn't finish until you get to the house.
Before he disappears,
Senua, you have to get him. Found a way to climb the tower. The ladder. Quick. What now? You can see it. Aligned to the truth. The branch.
Speak of a death moon, a light shaped like a half moon that appears inside a house and goes around the walls. I once saw the death moon appear at a farm, and first the shepherd died, then a guest died, and then the farmhands, and then the farmer and six of his men drowned at sea. That is not the end of it, because because the dead return to haunt the living. If you see the death moon, then beware, because there will be death in that house.
Probably came on just a tad bit too late, so I'm getting ready to shut off here as soon as I get done with this weird puzzle. Dinner. I'm gonna be nice to take my wife to B-dubs for dinner. Well, I gotta go wrangle up my kid part. But I might play some more when I get back, and if not, then I'll be playing around my normal time tonight. I'm just fixing visual puzzles, because you know that's what I have to do.
General, come to me. Where are you?
I'm here. I'm right here.
Are you in there? Come out if you want.
Find him. You have to find him.
The runes.
Focus.
The runes.
Damien! They're coming for me!
Well, that was... think I made it.
Yes. Because you need to eat too.
Oh. So I kind of had to burn? Find all these stupid symbols again.
There it is. Huh? It's close. It's close. Move away. Someone move away. You'll die. Run.
Run now. Run. 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 Fire. Oh, fuck this game sometime. No, that's coming from my wife's phone. That's my son's ringtone apparently on her phone. Fuck this game though sometimes.
It's the wrong door. Where's your sword?
shit.
It's close. Move away. Senua, move away.
I feel it.
You'll die.
You're dying. The burning.
She's dying.
The burning.
The burning.
Run. Run
now. They want to kill me.
And we're going to die again. No, it's because I forgot where the door was and I got lost.
There it is. It's close. It's close. Move away. Senua, move away.
Feel it.
You'll die.
You're dying. The burning.
She's dying.
The burning.
Run. Run now.
Run.
Run.
It's not safe here. Run.
And sadly, it doesn't have to follow the same physics that I do, because it can just seem to like walk through certain walls and whatnot.
It's unsafe. I feel unsafe. Where is it? I'm not safe.
You're dying.
You're lost. You're dying. This is what death feels
to be in order. It's just a really stupid puzzle. Like all the other stupid environmental puzzles in this game.
There it is. It's close. It's close. Move away. Senua, move away.
Feel it.
You'll die. Run. Run now.
Run. Run. It's not safe here. Run.
Oh, my God. Yep. Yep, and that thing just doesn't have to follow any of the physics of the map like we do. So it can just kind of beeline straight to you. And as you can see, the permadeath thing is fake. Because you figure I'd be dead by now. And I'd be starting over. Actually, no, I wouldn't, because I'd just stop playing at that point.
There it is. It's close. It's close. Move away. Senua, move away. You'll die.
You're dying.
Run.
Run
now.
And we're gonna die.
Run. It's not safe here. Run.
Senua.
You don't need your sword. You came through the wrong door. Where's your sword?
To defend yourself is that creature.
You can't.
They're coming for me.
It's not safe. I feel unsafe. Where is it?
I'm not safe.
You're dying.
You're lost. You're dying.
This is what death feels like.
Now the problem is I have to find my way back to the door without getting burned up. Thank you. Yeah, the problem is that this game is artificially long because of these sequences.
Shadow.
And it just kind of leaves a sour taste in your mouth because you play and it's like, oh man, this is kind of good. And then it's like, oh no, wait, I'm having to do this over and over and over. And it's not fun anymore.
What if they're right?
What? How would they know such a thing? Are they gods? None of us are. They're just people. Good people, but they're scared. They're afraid of what they can't see.
So that's frustrating in and of itself. That
they make up stories to fill.
It's a game that's basically artificially lengthening itself.
What if my father was right?
Or
you have to step out of this darkness.
Puzzle design, at least in my opinion.
And see who you really are. Like
I know, it's not everybody's opinion, but it's certainly mine.
You're not a monster.
By the way, that's only like two out of the four freaking puzzles I have to do. So I still have two more that I have to do that are like that one, where you can't even see the map, apparently. The map of blindness, where everything is super dark. Anyway. Alright, well, I'm gonna go. I will be back on later tonight. Until then, make sure you check out the You Like Worst Stuff podcast. I'd appreciate that. And give it a review if you like it. And if not, don't worry about it. Yeah. Like I said, two out of the four. There's still two more. And like one of them I know is the Maze of Blindness, which is where the entire thing is pitch black. And you can barely see your hand in front of you. So, hey guys, I'm going to go have some chicken or something and we'll be back on later. See ya.